It's Reverend Jay here, and I'm on the backside of my home in San Francisco. And today, I'd like to invite us to take a journey visiting sacred places, murals. Now, this is a graffiti mural that's on the backside of my home. And before this was up, it would be spray painting and leaving all kinds of messages, not very positive messages, up on my back fence. But the city, a few years back, invested in having artists come here to share their work. And as you can see, it has not been vandalized. One of the things that happens when murals are put up is that there's a feeling that the community is a part of it. The community owns it, and it tells part of the community story. So you can see right here, the mural goes all the way up for a few houses, and it tells the story of a community, so people honor it. There are various types of murals all throughout our places, and I'd like to visit it. It tells the story of the people who live there, past, present, and also future. So are you ready? As we travel throughout my neighborhood, the Outer Mission District of San Francisco, and also the Excelsior District, we find messages that depict what's important to the people in this neighborhood. Issues of violence, gentrification, and way too expensive rent are at the heart of people nowadays. Also sharing a bit of our history and who we are as diverse people of God. San Francisco has over 1,000 murals painted throughout the city, and the Mission District boasts the largest concentration of murals, and it ranges from depictions of religion, mosaics of culture, political statements, social movements, and it also reflects the variety and deep diversity of the people who live here in the city. The Mission District is like an outdoor art gallery, vibrant with colors. Back in the 1970s, local artists took to the streets and coated walls and fences with works of art. That tradition of covering the Mission District with murals continues to this day. Thank you. I'm standing in front of Presida Eye's Mural Arts, and it's a group of artists who have come together over the many decades to help beautify and tell the story of the people of the San Francisco Bay Area, where we come from, who we are, and who we are becoming. Many of the art that you see around us also memorializes loved ones or people or historical icons. And so as you look, I invite you to continue to wonder, to be curious. What's really amazing is that Presida Eyes here in the San Francisco Mission District, 24th Street, has a connection with us at St. Matthew's in San Mateo. Let's go see what that connection might be. Murals left behind remind us of those days gone past, of those wonder years, and of hope that springs eternal. Here I am at St. Matthew's on the backside playground of our school. And here's our mural. The mural community project was spearheaded by our own Cheryl Adedicon. And she invited Presida Eyes and our school and church community to envision what a wall would look like that spoke of our history, of who we are, past, present, and future.
The descendants of King Kamehameha also came to the first iteration of our school back in the late 1800s. They were instrumental in bringing surfing to the mainland United States.
In the Episcopal tradition, we believe that we are co-creators with God, and that as we build the kingdom of God, we not only build it in spirit, but we actually physically build it. Being a co-creator means we have the responsibility to create beauty, also as a sign of God's love and intention for us. These signs inspire us to live into who we are, to live into love. So I wonder for you, as we take a look briefly at murals, what might be a favorite mural for you that you've seen today? In fact, you might know of other murals that we haven't taken a look at yet. I wonder how we might be together, co-creators with God. God bless you, God keep you, and all the places that we are called to be, continue to live into love. Amen.